गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ 12th क्लास बायोलॉजी चैप्टर 10 माइक्रोब्स इन ह्यूमन वेलफेयर एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द होमवर्क सॉल्यूशंस ऑफ लेक्चर 3। एनसीईआरटी क्वेश्चंस 9 to 15 वर गिवन एज होमवर्क एंड दिस इज एनसीईआरटी क्वेश्चन नंबर 9। डू यू थिंक माइक्रोब्स कैन ऑल्सो बी यूज एज सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी? इफ यस, हाउ? सो हेयर यू नीड टू एक्सप्लेन any example in which energy is generated due to microbes action, right? So here you will describe about the gobar gas plant, okay? That how in a gobar gas plant microbes are responsible for the production of biogas, right? So you need to explain it with that example. So the answer will be yes, microbes can certainly be a source of energy. Some bacteria such as methanogens can be used to generate biogas or gobar gas in a biogas plant. So this was the answer for the example, and now you will explain that example, that how this energy is generated by microbes. Okay, so in a biogas plant under anaerobic conditions, biogas can be generated, right? Because these methanogens are anaerobic bacteria. The biogas plant consists of a concrete tank with a depth of nearly 10 to 15 feet, comprising of adequate outlets and inlets. Outlets for removal of the biogas and inlet for the addition of the slurry, right? The gathered dung is mixed with gathered dung in which methanogens are present, okay? Cow dung or any cattle dung is mixed with water for the formation of slurry and flung into the tank. The tank consists of digester which is filled with plenty of anaerobic methane producing bacteria, right? So in digester, those methanogens act on slurry. This produces biogas from the slurry. Biogas can be extracted through a pipe which can be used as a source of energy. The slurry that is used is removed from the outlet and used as a fertilizer. So like this you will explain it. Question number 10 of NCERT. Microbes can be used to decrease the use of chemical fertilizers and pesticides. Explain how this can be accomplished. So chemical fertilizers and pesticides can be replaced with biofertilizers and biocontrol agents with the help of microbes. Okay, microbes can be used as fertilizers and biocontrol agents. So in that case, we it will decrease the use of chemical fertilizers and pesticides. So here you need to explain that use of microbes with the help of some examples. Okay, so organic farming is carried out without the use of any pesticides and chemical fertilizers. So organic farming is a type of farming in which no chemical is used, okay, in the form of fertilizer or in the form of pesticide. So where no chemical is used, that type of farming is called organic farming. And in organic farming, microbes play a major role in that, okay. So biofertilizers involves picking advantageous microbes to help improve plant growth by supplying nutrients as biofertilizers. Are living entities that are known to increase the soil fertility. So in case of organic farming, microbes are used as biofertilizers, and these microbes can improve plant growth by supplying different nutrients which will act as biofertilizers and will increase the soil fertility. So there will be reduced use of chemical fertilizers. These are introduced into roots, seeds and soil in order to make nutrients available, right? So in different parts of plant it can be applied, like these microbes can be used to supply the nutrients to the plant, thus enriching it with organic and soil nutrients. Some species of cyanobacteria, you know, blue green algae, and bacteria and other bacteria like rhizobium, you can say, have the potential to fix the free atmospheric nitrogen. Right, cyanobacteria and rhizobium bacteria both can fix the atmospheric nitrogen. A symbiotic bacteria, rhizobium, is found in root nodules of leguminous plant, which fix the atmospheric nitrogen, and we can use that as a biofertilizer. Then some free living nitrogen fixing bacteria are also there, like एजोटोबैक्टर, एजोस्पाइरिलम, वाइल नोस्टोक, ऑसिलेटोरिया, एनाबिना आर सम नाइट्रोजन फिक्सिंग साइनोबैक्टीरिया. ओके, दीज आर एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सम ब्यूग्रीन एल्गी और साइनोबैक्टीरिया यू कैन से विच कैन फिक्स नाइट्रोजन एंड कैन बी यूज एज बायोफर्टिलाइजर. Okay, so these biofertilizers, all these free living nitrogen fixing bacteria, symbiotic nitrogen fixing bacteria and cyanobacteria, all these are biofertilizers and these are eco-friendly and cost-effective, right? On the other hand, microbes can also serve as biopesticide. Okay, so here we were explaining that how the chemical fertilizers use can be reduced with the help of microbes. Okay, now we will explain that how the chemical pesticide use can be reduced with the help of microbes. So here we will give that example, like microbes can also serve as biopesticides to check insect pest in plants. For example, Bacillus thuringiensis is a biopesticide and it produces a toxin which kills the insect pest. When an insect ate that plant, so the toxin released by Bacillus thuringiensis kills insect pest. Bacterial spores of the Bacillus thuringiensis are mixed with water and sprinkled in fields. These spores enter the gut of larva of that insect. Okay, so in the gut of larva of insect to release toxin, where the larva of various insects feed on crops. These toxins will released inside the gut of insect and will kill the insect. Likewise, this is another example. A free living fungi like Trichoderma are found in roots of higher plants, safeguarding them from pathogens. One more example is given here. Another biopesticide like Baculovirus is used as a biocontrol agent against many arthropods and insects. Now this is question number 11 of NCERT. Three water samples, namely river water, untreated sewage water and secondary effluent discharged from a sewage treatment plant, subjected to biochemical oxygen demand test, okay, BOD test. The samples were labeled ABC, but the laboratory attendant did not know which was which, right? It means all the samples were mixed. So the BOD values of three samples ABC were recorded as 20 milligram per liter, 8 milligram per liter and 400 milligram per liter respectively. Which sample of the water is most polluted? Can you assign the correct label to each, assuming the river water is relatively clean? Because here it is river water, untreated sewage water and secondary effluent. So which one is most polluted? This untreated sewage water, this is most polluted. After that, secondary effluent will be less polluted and river water will be least polluted. Okay, so here it is written that assuming the river water is relatively clean, okay, means it is in river after the treatment of water, after the sewage treatment. Okay, now let's see the answer. BOD, or you can say biochemical oxygen demand, refers to the amount of oxygen which would be consumed if all the organic matter in 1 liter of water were be oxidized by bacteria, right? So first you need to tell about the definition of BOD. This BOD test measures the rate of uptake of oxygen by microbes in a sample of water, right? Hence BOD is said to be measure of organic matter found in water. Therefore we can say greater the BOD of wastewater, the greater is the polluting potential. So it means the water having highest BOD will be most polluted, right? Sample A with BOD 20 mg per liter can be assigned as the secondary effluent discharged from a sewage treatment plant. Sample B with BOD 8 mg per liter can be assigned as river water, and sample C with 400 milligram can be assigned as untreated sewage water, okay, because this is the highest VOD here you can see, okay, and highest VOD is for the most polluted water, and most polluted water is untreated sewage water. Then on second number, you can see this number is there, 20 milligram, and on second number, the secondary effluent is polluted, and the least polluted water is of river and is having least BOD, okay, least BOD, that is 8 milligram per liter. This assignment is on the basis that highest BOD value is the sample carrying the most polluted water, so you can easily tell about that. Next question is, find out the name of microbes from which cyclosporine A, an immunosuppressive drug, and statins, that is a blood cholesterol lowering agent, are obtained. So this is a direct question. Cyclosporine is obtained from fungus Trichoderma polysporum. You need to tell the complete name. And statin is obtained from Moluscus purpureus. The next question is, the role of microbes in the following are as follows. Like you need to tell the role of microbes in single cell protein. So this is the role of microbes in single cell protein. You know, single cell protein is the protein obtained from microbes. Okay, so it refers to the harmless microbial cells that can be substituted for good proteins. Okay, so microbes are good source of protein. Some forms of microbial cells can be consumed as food enriched in minerals, proteins, fats, vitamins, and carbohydrates. For example, you can see here, like mushrooms are consumed. Okay, and mushrooms are fungi. Okay, so these are microbes used as food. And yeast is eaten by athletes as a source of protein. So single cell protein, microbes can be used. Next example is Methylophilus methylotropus, that is a bacteria that used to produce single cell protein. Also spirulina is used. So both these Methylophilus methylotropus and spirulina, these are cultivated on large scale on materials comprising starch like wastewater from potato, like on waste material these are grown. Okay, so these can be grown on molasses, straw, animal manure, and sewage. Okay, and these are very good source of protein. Next is role of microbes in soil. So the role of microbes is crucial in preserving the fertility of soil because these help in forming nutrient rich humus by the phenomena of decomposition. So decomposition is very important for the preservation of the fertility of soil, and that process of decomposition is performed by microbes. Several bacteria and cyanobacteria species have the potential to fix atmospheric nitrogen to a foam that can be used by a plant. Okay, so they are fixing that nitrogen and making the soil more fertile. A symbiotic bacteria, Rhizobium, is found in root nodules of leguminous plant. Some free nitrogen fixing bacteria like Azobacter, Azospirillum, and some nitrogen fixing bacteria, fixing cyanobacteria like Nostoc, Oscillatoria, Anabina are found here, which help in increasing the fertility of soil. So here you need to tell all these examples which are important for making our soil more fertile. Next question is, arrange the following in decreasing order. Most important first, okay? So most important material you need to write first. So decreasing order of their importance for the welfare of human society. Give reason for your answer. So biogas, citric acid, penicillin, and curd. Now you tell which one is most important for human being, for human welfare. So I think penicillin is most important because it is used as a antibiotic. Okay, penicillin is an antibiotic. It is used as a medicine to kill the pathogens, right? So it is most important. So penicillin is an antibiotic that kills pathogens which causes harmful diseases and infections, hence saving lives. So it is for saving lives. Therefore, it is most important. Then second is biogas. Third, on third number, there is curd. And on fourth number, there is citric acid. Now, let's see why biogas is on second number. Because it is, it serves as a non-polluting clean fuel, which is generated as a byproduct of sewage treatment. Okay, so it can prevent the environmental pollution, you can say. So it can be used to cook food as a source of lighting homes in remote areas. And after that, after biogas, next number is curd, and it has a high nutritional value, supplying vitamin B12. It helps in maintaining health of our gut and replaces harmful bacteria of the stomach with the beneficial one. And the on last number we have kept citric acid, which is used as a food preservative. Next question is, how do biofertilizers enrich the fertility of soil? So again, here in this question, you need to explain the same thing. I have explained in the previous question that how soil fertility is maintained, how microbes help in formation of soil, how they preserve the fertility of soil. So here also you will explain that thing with the example, with example of many microbes. Okay, so biofertilizers are living entities. First of all, you will tell about that. So biofertilizers are living entities that are known to increase soil fertility. They supply different nutrients to the plant and also increase the fertility of soil. After that, you will give the example of rhizobium as the symbiotic bacteria, some cyanobacteria, some free living bacteria like Azotobacter, Azospirillum. Okay, all these examples you need to explain here. Your today's homework is to do assignment that has been uploaded on Edwork, as this chapter has been completed.